हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल कीर्ति शिक्षाश्रम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर 6 क्लास 9, दैट इज योर लाइंस एंड एंगल्स। सो बिफोर वी गो फर्दर, वी शुड नो सम ऑफ द टर्म्स लाइक पैरेलल लाइंस, व्हाट इज ट्रांसवर्सल लाइंस, एक्सटीरियर एंगल, इंटीरियर एंगल एंड ऑल दोज थिंग्स। ओके, सो प्रीवियसली वी नो दैट व्हाट आर पैरेलल लाइंस। If two lines never intersect with each other, then they are called parallel lines. If this is a line, okay, this is a line AB and this is another line CD. If AB and CD never intersect with each other, then they are called parallel lines. Understand? Then what is a transversal? Next is, what is transversal? A line which intersects two or more lines at distinct points, that means different points, is called transversal. So here, this is a line, let this is P and this is Q. This intersect AB and intersect CD at different points, that means this is PQ intersects AB at this point, let this is as O, and PQ intersects CD at, let this is Q, this is M, this point. So here, this intersect both AB and CD at different points, that's why PQ is called the transversal of the AB and CD. Understand what is transversal? Then we should know what are exterior angles. So here we will understand this by using this figure. Okay, so in this figure, what are exterior angles? Those angles which are exterior means external, that means here 1, 2 and 8, 7. 1, 2 and 8, 7. These are outside these points, right? Outside these lines. So this area will be the interior and this area will be your exterior area. So 1, 2 and 8, 7 are exterior angles. Similarly, what are interior angles? Those are interior to the transversal, that means 4, 5 and 3, 6. 4, 5, 3 and 6. So these angles are interior angles. Understand what is exterior angle, what is interior angle? Okay, let's go to some terms like what are corresponding angles, what are alternate interior angles, what are alternate exterior angles, what is interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Okay, so here in this figure, what are corresponding angles? The angles which look similar or which looks the same. Right, so in this figure here, if this is a transversal to this line or this line intersects CD, here 5 is towards this, right, towards this. So like this angle, there is another angle 1, right? So this angle corresponds to this angle. These are the similar positions. Similarly, 4 and 8 are corresponding angles, 2 and 6 are corresponding angles, 3 and 7 are corresponding angles, right? So I can write it like pair, like 1, 5 are corresponding angles, right? Then 4 and 8 are corresponding angles, right? Then 3 and 7, and then 2 and 6. So these are corresponding angles. Understand? Okay, let's go to alternate interior angles. First of all, interior angles. So 4, 5, 6, 3, these 4 are interior angles. Alternate means opposite. Alternate interior. So here 4 is the alternate interior angle of 6. That means 4, 6. 4 angle is the alternate interior angle of 6. 6 angle is the alternate interior angle of 4. Similarly, 3 and 5. 3 and 5. So 3 and 5 are also alternate interior angles to each other. Then what are alternate exterior angles? So 1, 2 and 8, 7. are alternate exterior angles. So here 1 is opposite to 7. So 1, 7, 1 and 7, these are alternate exterior angles. And 2 and 8, these are also a pair of exterior angles. Okay, we'll go to the relationship between them. Okay, the last one is interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Interior angles on the same side of the transversal. So here interior angles are 4, 5, 6, 3, right? 4, 5, 6, 3, same side of the transversal. Okay, if this is the transversal, so 4 and 5 are in the same side of the transversal, that is 4, 5 and 3, 6. 4, 5 are in one side, right? 4, 5 are in one side and 3 and 6 are in another side. So 3 and 6 and 4 and 5. Okay, understand up to this, these terms? Okay, let's go to the axiom number 6.3. Here it is. So it states that if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, here it is given that AB parallel to your CD and PS is the transversal, then each pair of corresponding angle is equal. Then corresponding angles are always equal. That means this angle is equal to this angle, this angle is equal to this angle, this angle is equal to this angle, and this angle is equal to this angle. If considering this as 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, and this is 5, this is 6, this is 7, and this is 8, I can write corresponding angles are equal. That means one angle is equal to 5, 1 is equal to 5, 4 is equal to 8, then 2 is equal to 6, 2 is equal to 6, and lastly 3 is equal to 7. Understand? The corresponding angles are same according to axiom 6.3. What is axiom 6.4 states? Axiom 6.4 states that if a transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of corresponding angles is equal, then the two lines are parallel to each other. That means if one of the corresponding angles are equal, then these two are parallel. If given that one is 55 degree, this angle is 55 degree and this is 55 degree, so I can say that AB parallel to CD. Understand? Let's consider here, this is a line, this is a line, and this one is 55, this one is 55. These two are corresponding lines. If the corresponding lines are equal, I can say that this is L1, this is L2. L1 is parallel to L2. I can say that L1 parallel to L2. Understand up to this? This is all about axiom 6.3 and 6.4. So here is the theorem 6.2, and it states that if transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of alternate interior angles is equal. That means let us consider AB parallel to CD and PQ is the transversal. If AB parallel to CD and PS is the transversal, then pair of alternate interior angle is equal. That means this angle is equal to this angle and this angle is equal to this angle. We have to prove this, or this theorem 6.2 states that. Okay. So here it is given that AB parallel to CD and PQ is the transversal, intersect AB and CD at Q and R respectively. If AB parallel to CD, then I can write BQR angle is equal to PQA. Why? Because vertical opposite angles, this angle and this angle are vertical opposite angles. So I can write PQR is equal to PQA. Second thing is PQA angle, this angle PQA is equal to QRC, because these are given, or दिस एंगल इज इक्वल टू दिस एंगल, एज ए बी पैरेलल टू सी डी, दीज आर कॉल्ड योर कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स. सो दीज आर मेनली आई कैन राइट इट एज कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स. So here is the equation 1 where BQR is equal to PQA and here PQA is equal to QRC. From these two I can write BQR is equal to QRC, right? I can write BQR is equal to QRC. So here it is, BQR is equal to QRC. So these two are alternate interior angles, right? So you have to prove this. Understand up to this? So this is about your theorem 6.2 and here is your 6.3. If the transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of alternate interior angles is equal, then the two lines are parallel. What it means? If a transversal intersects two lines, let's consider here these two are lines and this is the transversal. A pair of alternate interior angles, if this angle is equal to this angle, this is 45 degree and this is 45 degree. If this equal to this, these two angles are equal, then I can say that this line parallel to this. This is your theorem 6.3. If a pair of, only one pair of interior opposite angles, alternate interior angles are equal or is equal, then I can say that these two lines are parallel. This is your theorem 6.3. Understand up to this? Next is your theorem 6.4 and what it states? If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is supplementary. What does it mean? Here let us consider L1 and L2 are two parallel lines and L3 intersect with each other. Okay, and it states that here there are parallel lines, okay, and these two angles, let this is 1, this is 2, are on the same side of the transversal, let this is 4, this is 5, this is 3, this is 4. So here 1 and 2 are on the same side of the transversal and 3 and 4 is on another side of the transversal. So it states that the theorem 6.4 states that if L1 parallel to L2 and L3 is a transversal, then 1 plus 2 is equal to 180 and 3 plus 4 is equal to 180. Okay, the interior angles of the same side of the transversal are supplementary to each other. That means the sum of these two angles should be 180. Understand up to this? This is your 6.4. Okay, what is 6.5? If a transversal intersects two lines such that a pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is supplementary, then the two lines are parallel. It is just opposite to 6.4. It states that if this is 1, this is 2, this is 4, it is given that if 1 plus 2 is equal to 180 or 3 plus 4 is equal to 180, then L1 parallel to L2. Okay, so this theorem states this: if a pair of alternate interior angles on the same side of the transversal, that is, if this is the transversal, right? So this is on the same side of the transversal. If these two are supplementary, that is, the sum of these two are 180 degree, then I can say that L1 parallel to L2. Understand? Okay, let's go to the next theorem, that is your theorem 6.6. What it says? Lines which are parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. Okay, that means here I can say if this is a line parallel to this, if L1 parallel to L2, L1 parallel to L2 and L2 is parallel to L3. Understand? Given that this parallel to this and this parallel to this, I can say that L1 parallel to L3. Understand? If L1 parallel to L2, L2 parallel to L3, then L1 parallel to L3. Understand? This is your theorem 6.6. We'll see the application of this. Okay, let's go to the example number 4. What it given? So here is your example number 4. PQ parallel, here is the figure, PQ parallel to RS, given that PQ parallel to RS. MXQ is equal to 135. Here this angle is 135. MYR is equal to 40 degree, this angle. Find XMY, we have to find out this angle, this whole angle, right? Let us draw a line AB parallel to PQ. We have just studied that if this parallel to this and this parallel to this, this implies this parallel to this and this parallel to this. Understand? Okay. Here, given that PQ parallel to RS, let's draw a line AB parallel to PQ. If AB parallel to PQ, then AB parallel to RS. Okay. From here, PQ parallel to AB, that means these are on the same side of the transversal. That means I can write QXM plus XMB angle is equal to 180 according to theorem 6.4. Similarly, this is your equation 1, or this is let this like this. Okay, here MYR, this angle is equal to YMB angle, because these two are alternate interior opposite angles. We know that if two lines are parallel, then alternate interior opposite angles are equal. This means BMY or R, BMY is equal to MYR. Right? Understand? Up to this, BMY is equal to MYR, which is equal to 40 degree. Right? From here, I can calculate XMB as 45 degree. Already given this is 35. So XMB plus QXM is equal to 180. So from here, I can calculate XMB is equal to 45. Similarly, this angle is equal to this angle. This implies BMY is equal to 40 degree. So XMY is equal to XMB plus BMY. XMY is equal to XMB plus BMY. So this, I have calculated this as 45 and this is 40. That means XMY is equal to 45 plus 40 is equal to 85. Understand up to this? So this is your example number 4. Understand? Okay, let's go to the next example, that is your example number 5. So here is your example. If a transversal intersects two lines such that the bisector of a pair of corresponding angles are parallel, then prove that two lines are parallel. And what the statement states? If PQ is a line and RS is another line, and AD, here AD is the intersector, or AD intersects PQ and RS at B and C respectively. Okay, and given that here ABQ and BCS, two corresponding angles, here it is given that the pair of corresponding, okay, and BE and CZ are bisector of ABQ and BCS respectively. Understand? The question is given that, and given that BE parallel to CG, this is given, and we have to find out, or we have to prove that PQ parallel to RS. Okay, given that this BE bisects this and CG bisect this angle, and BE parallel to CG, we have to find out PQ parallel to RS. Okay, let's solve this. Here I have written the given things. So given that BE is the bisector of ABQ, CG is the bisector of BCS, BE parallel to CG, as I have told you. Okay, here BE parallel to CG and AD is the intersector. Here they see BE parallel to CG, right? If this, okay, rotate it, this parallel to this, so this may be the bisector, or this may be the intersector. So this is the transversal and these two are corresponding angles, right? ABE and BCG, these are corresponding angles. So if this parallel to this, or BE parallel to CG, then ABE angle is equal to BCG angle, right? So I am writing here ABE is equal to BCG, then multiply 2 with it. 2 of ABE is equal to 2 of BCG. So it is given that this is the bisector of this angle. So twice of this angle will be this full angle, right? So twice of ABE will be ABQ, and twice of BCG is equal to BCS. So this will be, I can write ABQ is equal to BCS, right? If he look here, ABQ angle, ABQ is equal to BCS. This implies I can say that BQ parallel to CS, because these two are corresponding angles. We have already studied, if corresponding angles are equal, then these two, the lines are parallel. So from here I can write BQ is parallel to CS. So from here I can write BQ parallel to CS, because these two are corresponding angles. What? These two are corresponding angles. This implies BQ parallel to CS. BQ is equal to PQ. So BQ, I can write BQ as PQ parallel to CS as RS. So, understand? Okay, let's go to the last example, that is your example number 6. So here is the question. In this figure, it is given that AB parallel to CD, AB parallel to CD, and CD parallel to EF. We have already studied in the theorem that if two lines are parallel to the same line, then these two are parallel. That means if AB parallel to CD and CD parallel to EF, then AB parallel to CEF. Okay, so here it is given that this angle is 90 degree. EA perpendicular to AB, that means this angle is 90 degree, and this angle is your 55 degree, and this is stated as x, y, and z. We have to find out the value of x, y, z. So here, if CD is parallel to EF and this is the transversal, so these two angles, this angle and this angle, are on the same side of the transversal. We have already studied, if two lines are parallel, then the angles on the same side of the transversal are what? The sum is 180 degree. That means 55 plus y is equal to 180, right? So here I can write y plus 55 as 180. This implies I can calculate y is equal to 125, because here it is given 55. So y is equal to 125. If y is equal to 125, these two are parallel, right? So x is equal to y, because these are corresponding angles, na? So I can write x is equal to y as x and y are corresponding angles. Now we have to calculate z also. So ABE is a triangle, right? By applying angle sum property, I can calculate this, because if this is x, or x is equal to y, this means 125 degree. If this is 125 degree, I can calculate this. What? How much? This will be your 55 degree. If this is 55 and this is your z, if this is 5, this is z, and this is 90, putting angle sum property, I can calculate z. What I am doing here, like this. So I can, here it is 180 minus 125, what I have done here. So this is your z, calculation of z by applying angle sum property. Or we can calculate, like in this triangle ABE, exterior angle is x, right? Exterior angle is the sum of interior opposite angle. That means I can write ax is equal to a angle plus z, this plus z, right? So I can write here ax is equal to aeb plus eab, right? From here I can calculate x is equal to 125, AEB plus EAB is equal to 90 given, Z is equal to 125, 90, that is your 35 degree. I can calculate the solution or the value of Z in both the ways. So we have found x is equal to 125, y is equal to 125, and Z is equal to 35. This is all about your examples and some basics. So we will study the example, the exercise 6.2 in the next video. So if you like the video, just press the like button and do subscribe my channel, and please share with your friends so that they will be get benefited in the lockdown period. ओके, प्रेस द बेल आइकन सो दैट यू यू विल गेट द नोटिफिकेशन फॉर द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. थैंक यू.